Hello students, I am Sachitrakas. Welcome to Tars Physics. We are continuing current electricity, chapter number 3, class 12. In just previous lecture, we have started discussion on a beautiful concept, that is combination of cells. Okay, combination of cells. So we have discussed, cells may be connected either in series or in parallel. Okay, and finally, if we combine both series and parallel, it means if a circuit has both series combination and parallel combination, then we do say it mixed combination of cells. In previous lecture, we have completed the discussion on combination of cells in series. We have discussed all fundamental concepts on combination of cells in series, and also we have approached some numericals. Okay, so again, in this lecture, as I have divided the whole combination of cells into three parts. In previous lecture, we have discussed cells combined in series, and in this lecture, we'll discuss the combination of cells in parallel. Cells combined in parallel. We'll discuss the basic concept, and also we'll find what is the condition to get maximum current in parallel combination of cells. As we have discussed, cells are combined in series to get maximum voltage. Cells are combined in parallel to get maximum current, and mixed grouping of cells or mixed combination of cells is used to get maximum power from the combination of cells. Okay? So cells in parallel or combination of cells in parallel is very useful to get maximum current. Okay? Let's start from basic concept. The cells may have equal EMFs, or the cells may have different EMFs. So we'll use a number of cells, but let's think about the basic concept. Here I have taken two points, A and B. And there are two cells. There are two cells having EMF E1 and E2, and internal resistances R1 and R2 are shown in figure. Also, we may use any external resistance to find current in the circuit. Okay. Here, just let's find what is the equivalent EMF of combination of these two cells, and what is equivalent resistance, internal resistance. Cells have internal resistances. What is equivalent resistance of this combination of two cells? Again, we may use number of cells if we get the basic concept. So first, let's think about correct combination of cells. This is correct combination of cells. I am writing the concept, you may note down it, or you may pause the video to understand the concept. Okay. First, what is basic definition of cells combined in parallel? Cells are combined in parallel. Cells are combined in parallel if positive terminals of all cells are connected. Positive terminals of all cells are connected to a common point, and negative terminals of all cells are connected to another common point. Okay? So a number of cells, we have taken here only two cells. We may take number of cells. Okay? A number of cells are two cells, whatever may be the number. A number of cells are said to be connected in parallel. Number of cells are said to be connected in parallel if positive terminal. If positive terminal of all cells are connected to a common point. Here we may take common point A, and negative terminals and negative terminals of all cells are connected to another common point. Positive terminals are connected to a common point, that common point is A, and negative terminals are connected to another common point, that common point is B. And of course, we are considering here a part of circuit, a part of circuit. Okay? We may complete the circuit by using an external resistance so as to get current through the external resistance or load resistance. Here our aim is to get what is equivalent EMF and equivalent internal resistance of these two cells combined in parallel. Here we have taken EMF of the cells are not equal but different. EMF of the cells are E1 and E2, and internal resistances are R1 and R2. Positive terminals of the both cells are connected to a common point A, and negative terminals of both the cells are connected to a common point B. Okay, then how to find equivalent EMF of the combination of cells? Okay, I have divided the path AMNB, and another path is APQB. Okay, and as we know, if potential of A, let V1, and potential of B, let V2. Okay, I am erasing it now. I think you have already taken P dot D, potential difference, left, potential difference between A and B, potential difference between A and B, left, delta B, or we may take B. Potential difference between A and B is delta V, or we are taking here V. And as per our general expression for potential difference, we know it. Potential difference V is equal to E minus IR. V is equal to E minus IR, or EMF is equal to V plus IR. We know it from our previous discussion. Okay, then potential difference between A and B is V. Okay, then potential difference V, considering the path AMNB. Okay, so potential difference between A and B is V. And V is equal to E minus IR as per our general expression. Considering considering the past AMNB, potential difference between A and B is B. Then here, B is equal to, in this path, B is equal to, in place of EMF, we may take E1 minus C. Let total current entering here is I, which is divided into two branches. In this branch, current is I1, and in this branch, current is I2. Then, potential difference between A and B, potential difference between A and B is EMF E1 minus current in this branch. Current is I1, and internal resistance, is R1. And this implies I1 R1 is equal to E1 minus V. And finally we will get current I1 is equal to E1 minus V divided by R1. From this expression it is very clear that I1 is equal to E1 minus V divided by R1. Again, considering another path, potential difference between A and B, considering another path, A, P, Q, B. Considering the path A, P, Q. Again, potential difference between A and B. Potential difference between A and B, we have assumed V. Then again V is equal to, in this path, EMF is E2 minus I, here current is I2, and internal resistance is R. In similar way, we can take here E1 minus V divided by R1, here E2 minus V divided by R2, solving it, we will get expression for I2. According to Kirchhoff's first law, according to Kirchhoff's current law, KCL, total current is I, which is divided into two branches at junction B. Then I is equal to I1 plus I2. Sum of incoming current to junction B is I, and sum of outgoing currents I1 plus I2. Or you may see here also, I1 and I2 are incoming current to junction A, and outgoing current is I. Then as per Kirchhoff's first law, I is equal to I1 plus I2. I is equal to I1 plus I2. It is very simple. Then, these are expressions for I1 and I2. These are expressions of I1 and I2. And putting these expressions in this equation, I is equal to I1 means E1 minus V divided by R1, plus I2, E2 minus V divided by R2. Now let's solve it very simple now. And I is equal to E1 divided by R1 minus V divided by R1 plus E2 divided by R2 minus V divided by R2. Too simple. Then I is equal to E1 divided by R1 plus E2 divided by R2 minus minus bring minus common minus v. From these two minus v bring it common, and inside bracket we will get 1 by r1 plus 1 by r2. Okay. Fine. Then from this expression we will get v v into 1 by r1 plus 1 by r2 is equal v into 1 by r1 plus 1 by r2 is equal to just interchange, bring v into 1 by r1 plus 1 by r2 into left side, and bring I, this is I, bring I to right side. Okay. Now, v is equal to minus I whole divided by this is expression for V potential difference between A and B. Then finally we may write V is equal to equal to 1 by r1 plus 1 by r2 divided in both e1 by r1 plus e2 by r2 divided by 1 by r1 plus 1 by r2 minus I divided by I divided by 1 by r1 plus 1 by r2. Let's write it. Can I read it now? We know the general expression for potential difference, and we got this expression. Now we have to compare it. Okay. For combination of cells, general expression for potential difference is E minus I R. And we may write V is equal to, for combination of cells, this is equivalent EMF, minus I, total current is I, potential difference between A and B is V. Then total internal resistance means equivalent internal resistance. And we have got V is equal to Now let's compare. Potential difference V. Then what we got? For this combination of cells, equivalent EMF, in place of equivalent EMF, we have got expression for equivalent EMF. Is it clear? Is it easier? Okay. Then minus I is total current, into R equivalent. equivalent internal resistance. Then this is equivalent resistance I into equivalent resistance C. I can write it I into 1 divided by I into 1 divided by 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2. This equation means this expression may be written in this way also. Then equivalent internal resistance is 1 divided by 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2. Then just take reciprocal. 1 by equivalent internal resistance is 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2. You know it. If resistance is in parallel, then the reciprocal of equivalent resistance is sum of reciprocal of resistances in parallel. Okay. Suppose we have taken a number of cells in parallel. Then what is general expression? Now I erase it. To have general expression. Equivalent EMFC E1 by R1 plus E2 by R2 plus E3 by R3 means we can write sum of E by R divided by sum of 1 by R. Okay? Sum of 1 by R, 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. Sum of 1 by R, sum of E by R. Okay, so this is, and this is the general expression. 1 by equivalent resistance is sum of reciprocal of internal resistances. Reciprocal of equivalent internal resistance is sum of reciprocal of internal resistance is too easier. Here one thing you may remember. For wrong combination of cells, if polarity of any cell, we are now considering two cells. Suppose polarity of this cell is reversed. Okay. Just you remember, this is the general expression. Now I will erase it. Suppose this is first cell, EMF E1, internal resistance R1. This is second cell. Let polarities of second cell is reversed. What we have discussed? The correct combination in parallel grouping of cells, positive terminals of all cells should be connected to a common point, and negative terminals of all cells should be connected to another common point. Here, EMF internal resistance R this is B and this is EMF C. Positive terminal of first cell and negative terminal of second cell are connected to a common point. This is not correct combination. This is wrong combination. Between two cells, if polarities of one cell is reversed, then the cells are not in correct combination. Okay. Here you may take the expression E equivalent is and R equivalent is reciprocal of equivalent internal resistance same 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2. It will not change. Thus, just remember, if one of the cell is reversed, then take it negative. Here, you should remember E1 is greater than E2. E1, magnitude of E1 is greater than E2, and E2 is reversed, means polarities of second cell is reversed, so just take it negative. Okay. Again, we will see it in numerical. Okay. Now, we will discuss how to get maximum current from parallel combination of cells. Okay. How to get maximum current from parallel combination of cells. Okay. We may take different EMFs in parallel, okay? But let's consider, we have got how to get equivalent EMF. If a number of cells are connected in parallel, equivalent EMF is sum of E by R divided by sum of 1 by R, okay? Now let's consider some identical cells, a number of identical cells are connected in parallel. Let EMF of each cell is E, internal resistance of each cell is R. We are considering M number of cells. Okay. Okay, all these cells are in correct combination because positive terminals of all cells means M number of cells. not three cells, but M number of cells. Positive terminal of all cells are connected to a common point. Negative terminals of all cells are connected to a common point. Then accordingly, we may take flow of current and total current is, let I equivalent. Total current is I equivalent. Okay. Now we will make an equivalent circuit. Okay. Then combine all the cells to get equivalent EMF. One thing you know, children, volt remains same in parallel. So, if all the cells are identical and EMF of each cell is E, then obviously equivalent EMF will be E. Again, this is equivalent internal resistance. Internal resistance of the cells is same. R, M number of cells. So, there are M number of internal resistances in parallel. And as we know, R equivalent will be R by. And finally, this is external resistance. And current is
I E.
We'll find the condition for maximum current O. You may think how equivalent EMF is. I have discussed about the basic concept. Voltage remains same in parallel. Units of EMF is volt. So identical cells are connected in parallel. Whatever be the number of cells, 1000 or 100, but total EMF or equivalent EMF is E. Of course, you may use your generalized formula. Equivalent EMF is sum of E by R divided by sum of 1 by R. Means, equivalent EMF is E by R plus E by R plus E by R up to N number. N numbers. Up to N numbers and divided by 1 by R plus 1 by R plus 1 by R up to N numbers. Then what will you get? Equivalent EMF is up to M into E by R. Divided by, this is also M into 1 by R. M into 1 by R. M get cancelled, R get cancelled, then result is E. It's a number of identical cells are correctly combined in parallel. Then equivalent EMF is E. Okay? And of course, equivalent internal resistance R equivalent is 1 by R plus 1 by R plus 1 by R up to N. So, reciprocal of equivalent resistance is M by R and equivalent internal resistance is R by M. Okay? Now, what is equivalent current? Now, what is the equivalent current? Okay. Then equivalent current in the circuit is total EMF, equivalent EMF, divided by total resistance. Here, external resistance is R and internal resistance is R equivalent. And equivalent current or effective current. E equivalent is E. External resistance is R and internal resistance is R by M. Is it clear? You may add it. Effective current. E divided by, and finally we may get effective current is M E divided by this is expression for effective current in the circuit. Then how to get maximum current from combination of cells in parallel? Here, all the cells have same EMF and all the cells are correctly combined. Okay. As we have discussed in series, if external resistance is much more or much less as compared to internal resistance, total internal resistance, here is a similar discussion. Number one, if external resistance is much more
as compared to total internal resistance.
If external resistance is much more as compared to total internal resistance, of course, we may take the generalized expression, effective current is E by R plus solving it, we will get this one.
Number one, if external resistance is much more as compared to
total equivalent internal resistance, is R by M. If external resistance is much more, then we may neglect the total internal resistance.
Okay. Then in this case, effective current is E by R, that's where
R. EMF divided by resistance, volt divided by ohm is ampere, means current. And this is the current due to a single cell. If we neglect internal resistance, then if we use n number of cells, identical cells in parallel, then effective current is current due to a single cell.
Next, if external resistance, you may take very small as compared to
total equivalent internal resistance, means if external resistance is neglected, then
effective current in the circuit from this expression, external resistance is neglected, then this is E by R by M, or M into
E by R. Okay. M into
E by R.
Then E by R, volt divided by ohm is ampere.
Then we may take
MR. Okay. So, if external resistance is much less as compared to total internal resistance, means if external resistance is neglected, then current is maximum m times current due to a single cell.
This is the condition
for maximum current from parallel combination of cells if external resistance is much less as compared to total internal resistance or equivalent internal resistance. Okay, let's have some numericals, some one or two fundamental numericals, okay, about wrong combination and about correct combination. Okay. Suppose we are given three cells. I am showing in figure. Suppose three cells are given. The cells, first cell of EMF 1 volt, internal resistance 1 ohm. Accordingly, second cell, EMF is 2 volt, internal resistance is 2 ohm. Third cell, EMF is 3 volt, internal resistance is 1 ohm. Then it is asked.
From the given figure, find potential difference between P and Q.
Find potential difference between P and Q. See, this is a part of circuit and this is not completed. Means there is no flow of current. Okay? If there is no flow of current, then potential difference is equal to EMF. Potential difference is equal to EMF, as we have discussed from very beginning. Okay?
Then potential difference V between PQ. Potential difference between PQ.
It is equal to effective EMF or equivalent EMF.
And this is equal to E1 by R1 plus E2 by R2 plus E3 by R3 divided by 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by
R3. This is formula for equivalent EMF. This is also equal to potential difference between P and Q.
Okay? Then E1 is 1 volt, internal resistance is 1 ohm, E2 is 2 volt, internal resistance is 2 ohm, E3 is 3 volt, internal resistance is 1 ohm, divided by 1 by R1, 1. See, this is E1, this is R1, this is E2, this is R2, this is E3, this is we just put the values 1 by 1 plus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 1. The sum is, this is 1 plus 1 plus 3. 1 plus 1 plus 3 divided by, this is 1 plus 1 by 2 plus 1. Okay. Now the sum is equivalent, potential difference between P and Q, 3 plus 1 plus 1, this is 5, and now add it, LCM is 2, 2 plus 1 plus 2, then it is 2 volt, very easy. Okay. Now let's take 3 cells with one of the cell which is wrongly connected, means polarities of one cell is reversed. Polarities of one cell is reversed. Very easy. We have to find equivalent EMF and equivalent internal resistance. Okay. Suppose 3 cells are given. These are 3 cells, EMF of first cell, E1, and internal resistance is, let's 6 ohm, you may take any value, and EMF of this cell, let E2 is equal to 6 volt, and internal resistance is 3 ohm, this is third cell, let EMF is E3. E3 let 12 volt, and this is EMF, this is internal resistance, let this internal resistance is again 6 ohm. Here the cells are not in correct combination. This is a common point. Let this is P. This is a common point.
Let this point is Q. As per our general discussion, in correct combination of cells, positive terminal of all cells are connected to a common point, and negative terminals of all cells should be connected to another common point. Okay. Here,
positive terminal of these two cells
are connected to a common point B, but negative terminal of second cell is connected to point P. Okay. Two cells, positive terminal of two cells and negative terminal of one cell are connected to a common point. So this is not correct combination. This is not correct combination. Then how can we find? Okay. We have to find equivalent EMF. What is general formula for correct combination?
We have taken three cells.
This is formula for correct combination of cells, but here the polarities of this cell is reversed. Just take it negative.
Just take it negative.
Of course, you may apply Kirchhoff's law, as we have discussed in cells in series, to get potential difference. We'll get the same result. I'm not deriving here, just remember it. The terminals of a cell is reversed, then take it negative.
Then now let's calculate E1, 18 volt R1, 6 ohm, minus E2, 6 volt R2, 3 ohm, plus E3, 12 volt R3, 6 ohm, divided by 1 by R1, plus 1 by R2, plus 1 by R3. Then the E equivalent is just R8. 18 divided by 6, 3. Minus 6 divided by 3, 2. 12 divided by 6, 2. 3 minus 2 plus divided by 636, LCM will be 18, then this is 3 plus 6 plus 3. And E equivalent is 2 get cancelled, 3 divided by 6 plus 3, 9 plus 3, 12 divided by 8, and it will be 3 into 8 divided by 12, this is 4. 18 by 4. Okay, this is 4, 18 by 4 or 9 by 2, that's equals to 4.5 volt. And in very similar way, we may calculate equivalent internal resistance, that is same in parallel. 1 by equivalent internal resistance, 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3.
Already we have calculated this. This is 12 by 8. 1 by equivalent internal resistance, 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. We have got 12 by 8, means equivalent internal resistance is 18 by 12. That is equals to, this is 6 divided by 3 by 2 means 1.5 ohm. 3 by 2, 1.5 ohm. This is equivalent internal resistance and this is equivalent EMF of the circuit. Okay. So just apply the fundamental, you can approach any range of numerical. We have discussed the basic thoughts, and I hope this lecture will be helpful for you or useful for you. Thanks, my children. Thanks.